Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Brittany Simon. Thank you so much for being here. I hope you're having a great day. In today's video, I want to talk about dating, I guess, but through an anime lens, but not really, but sort of. I was thinking about this because yesterday I did a photo shoot, turned out super cute, and I was thinking of Rock Lee because I'm watching Naruto and I'm on the Shippuden part of Naruto. I never watched it when I was a kid. It wasn't one of the animes I watched, and I'm watching it as an adult now because my brother really loves it and everyone's telling me to watch it, and apparently it was really the shit at one point and I just completely missed it during my anime youth. I guess I was focusing on different animes, or maybe this was the time when I was rapidly reading because I've read thousands of books at this point, so maybe it was just because I was reading at the time, but either way I missed it, and so it's not something that I like because of nostalgia. I'm actually just kind of enjoying it for a casual experience, but at the same time loving specific characters like Rock Lee, and I was thinking about how I'd love to have a kid as determined and optimistic as Rock Lee. Right? All right, so what does this have to do with what I'm thinking about in terms of dating? Well, I was thinking about all those man on the street videos I've seen of guys asking girls, like, would you date a guy who likes anime? All
right. Would you date a guy that watches anime?
No.
This is a done deal. If you see the cartoons, it's a wrap. It's cool.
I think it's unattractive.
Really?
Yeah, honestly.
Hey, hold up, time out. we're gonna fix it. So, you never watched it?
No, I've never watched anime before.
So, say your boyfriend watched it, what would you do?
I mean, it's okay. Like, I would, like, kind of accept it, but, like, I wouldn't find it as one of the attractions.
If he invited you to watch it, would you?
It depends on the scale of how much I like him. If it's, like, a 5, then probably not.
I got you. So I'm not going to date you, obviously. Yeah. I'm going to get your number, but, like, nah, not anymore. Like, say your boyfriend watched it. Is that a problem?
Hell yeah, that's a problem. I feel like guys who watch a lot of anime just...
I would not want my boyfriend to like anime.
Really?
I don't know. I just feel like there's a stigma to it.
And universally speaking, like, most girls are like, no, because they think it's, like, similar to gaming. Would you date a guy who games? Funny enough, I can't date a guy. I wouldn't be able to marry because I'm looking for marriage, like 6 anime kids building a guild of our own marriage. And I couldn't imagine getting married to someone who didn't watch anime because I watch a lot of anime. It's just a form of art that I like. It's the way I like to consume story. I like to read as well. I like documentaries and movies as much as the next person, but I love anime the most. I mean, the fight scenes alone, like, so good. The romantic struggle, the tension, the good role models, it's just too much to deny. And I don't want to deny my kids it. So I'm thinking of somebody that I'm going to marry who's going to want to show our kids our favorite animes. Like, I'm already thinking, okay, I want to show my sons Rock Lee. I want to show them how you can be determined and optimistic. Even if you grow up without the thing that, you know, the thing we've been told we need more than anything, you can still somehow make it because you can form chosen family. The point is that I want my kids to have access to diverse storylines. And though anime repeats a lot of things, as most story mediums do, it's still really good. And so there's a lot of things that I want to show my kids. Like, I want to show my daughters Yona of the Dawn. I want them to see what it's like to be around a man who's good and still teases you and still has fun with you and still is a friend and a protector and a lover. I want them to see what it's like to be a woman who's strong, who's smart, who can be capable, who can change. Like, I want my kids to have access to stories. And yes, I can watch Lord of the Rings with them, which I will. And I can watch Tombstone and all these really fun movies as they get older. But the truth is that they're going to need things to consume as kids. And Disney is cool. Disney's great. I mean, I have a goddamn Disney tattoo. So, like, I definitely have been, you know, I've been that person. Okay, I get it. And right now, I'm that anime mom. I'm not a mom yet, but I will be. Applications and the links down below. Just kidding. But, like, seriously, I know anime is going to be a part of my kid's life. So it has to be a part of my partner's life. My best friend of 22 years, you guys have seen her on this channel. She doesn't watch anime. And somehow we've managed to be friends our whole life. But could we ever be lovers? No. And it's not because she's a girl. You know what I mean? It's literally because, like, we want to raise our kids differently. She's more into, and I am as well, 90s classics, Seinfeld and Will and Grace and stuff like that, which I think is great too. Absolutely want to raise my kids with that. But to be honest, I think a lot of life lessons comes out of anime, comes out of things that are geared towards quote unquote children. I think have some of the best life lessons. I mean, look at any Miyazaki film, which is so beautifully done. And my parents, immigrants from Iraq, raised us on anime. We were raised with Sailor Moon and Dragon Ball Z and Miyazaki. And frankly, I like my siblings. I like my family. We're our own little anime guild in and of itself. So much of our value systems, like a lot of our philosophy conversations stem from anime, a lot of our exploration. I mean, look at Attack on Titan. Look at the questions that Attack on Titan poses. Look at the way it challenges us to see that we're really the, you know, the two sides of the same coin. And human beings are generally that. So I guess all of this to say that I just couldn't date a person who didn't watch anime. For me, it's an opportunity for intimacy, an opportunity to cuddle, an opportunity to explore fantasies. I mean, I'm going to be real with you girls, like, anime, love it. Into those characters, definitely sexualizing cartoon characters, definitely hopped over to hentai, definitely had my moments, definitely own a tentacle dildo. Bad dragon, man. It's all about those bad dragons. I definitely am kinky. So for those people who are like, I don't watch anime because it's like hentai and it's weird. Yeah, I'm weird though. I mean, if you guys think like weird incest storylines on, you know, Vampire Knight is weird, do not date me because my imagination is weirder than any anime I have ever seen. All right. I'd love to know your answers in the sections down below about your own dating life. Could you date someone who watched anime? I know a lot of you don't actually watch anime in my audience. So I am curious on what's the thing for you where you're like, okay, if they don't do this, if they don't watch this, like if we're not going to raise our kids like watching this together, like what's the point? What's that thing for you? All right, talk to you guys soon. Bye.